With us now, Celtics owner Wyc Grousbeck. And Wyc, what's this year been like for you watching these games? I mean, they're so entertaining for us to watch. You know, 8 straight game wins, best record in the NBA by far, only Minnesota's 5 games back in second place. What's it like for you?
Every game is so stressful. So, you know, it is stressful. It's exciting, but I want it so badly, you know, for the guys, not just for me. I want it for everybody, for the fans. I want every win seems super important, which, you know, is kind of crazy after 21 years in. But everything seems to matter so much. And I, you know, it's a lot easier for me to be at the games. The game goes by faster. I have a lot more fun. And if I just have to watch them at home or on the road somewhere and just watching them on TV, it's very, very difficult. It's really stressful. So, I mean, I'm the happiest guy on the planet. There's no question. But the games, you know, they're a little anxious.
Did you guys make the bold move, right? I mean, you could have run it back. You're on the cusp of going to the NBA Finals last year. And you know, people wouldn't have blamed you. You make the bold move. You go out and get Jrue Holiday and Kristaps Porzingis. Did you ever think that they would fit in so quick, so seamlessly, and have the chemistry they have this early in the season?
Oh, it's unbelievable how great they've been and how great everybody's raised the game, and they've all knit together. You know, I mean, it's just, it's a really great team to watch. But I walked in, I've said this to somebody else the other day, but I walked in and met with Joe and Brad, and I just said, I know one thing, we're not bringing this team back. That was over the summer. It was 2 years in a row of really good teams that fell short. And in my view, they were inconsistent. We were hot and cold, high and low, and we lost. And we lost to two good teams, the Warriors and the Heat, but we lost. And I just said, we're not bringing it back. We're not running it back. Period. That's my decision. Now you tell me what changes we ought to make, guys, or let's do it together. But I wanted their recommendations. And so I set it out there. We're not bringing the team back, and we didn't bring the team back. Did I know we were going to get Porzingis and Holiday? No, I did not. And is that the genius of Brad? Yes. Brad is unbelievable and deserves all the credit in the world.
And just the way they fit in. And it seems like this team really likes each other. Even when you just watch the body language on the floor at the game, anytime Cornette scores, everybody's cheering for him. You know, anytime KP, and we heard the stories, he and Jalen riding to practice together and hanging out.
You know, cookies so, and cream.
Yeah. It seems like these guys, like they genuinely care for one another.
And when you're winning, it's easier to all get along. It gets a little tougher probably if you're losing a bunch of games. But success is creating more success here. It's creating more of a brotherhood. But it's been that way since the beginning of the year. Jrue Holiday comes in. Porzingis comes in, hasn't stopped smiling since he got here. And Jrue has, of course, a championship from the Milwaukee days. You know, there's a lot. There's just a lot to like about the team. We've got a third of the season left, or something like that, 25 games or so, and then hopefully the playoff run. So we're just getting started. We haven't accomplished anything yet, but it's a great team to watch. I'm really happy to have them here.
Hey, we're the NBA Finals on Channel 5, so you know we know who we're rooting for over here. Joe Mazzulla, I've at least noticed, and some of the other colleagues in the media, is how much more comfortable he looks this year, just dealing with us in game. Is that from just having another year? Is that from having a training camp and being with the team? Is that having, you know, his own assistant coaches? What have you noticed?
I don't know. I just, you know, Joe is Joe. He is his own person and a unique person. I met him before we promoted him. I had gotten to know him back in the playoffs when we were in Milwaukee for an extended stay a couple years ago. And I just found him really compelling, like a guy that I would follow if I were an athlete on this team. I had been coached back in college in a different sport. And, you know, that's how I make these recommendations or decisions, is I kind of think of what would I do if I were on this team. You know, would I follow this person? Would I respect them? And he just has those charismatic, it's more than charisma. It's substance and it's authentic. And so he's a very authentic person. He's grown into enjoying dealing with the media more, I think. I think he's really having more fun with it.
Yeah.
And you know, that's, you know, I guess it's part of the job description, but really you got to win the games and he's also performing in that level.
Yes, and he seems to be having fun with us, and we him. Wyc, before we let you go, any superstitions here during this 8-game streak? Is there anything you won't do, will do when the team's hot like this?
Oh, man. I was superstitious back in the day and drove a certain car. Not that I had that. I think I had two, but there was only one of them I was driving, and this and that, and the other thing. These days, I don't do that. If I ever feel like I need to be lucky, I put the championship ring on and hope that I get another one.
Wyc Grousbeck, Celtics owner, we appreciate it. This was a lot of fun. Thanks, Wyc.
Always great seeing you, Duke. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.